What's up, everybody? Welcome to the channel, Rockin' the Country. Hope you're having a good day. I mean, that just makes things better, doesn't it? I'm Don, and today I'm doing a subscriber request. And first, I want to give a shout out to my friend Debbie, because I'm wearing a shirt that I bought when we went out. We had brunch, well, as of when you see this, about a week ago, and it was one of those days where it was like chilly at first. So I put on one shirt, but then it got warm pretty quickly, like out of the blue, sun came out and all this. And so I was starting to roast up. So I'm like, hey, let's duck into this Lululemon store. And it happened to be right there. And so I grabbed this shirt. So Debbie, shout out to you. I don't know if you'll watch this. She's an awesome person. I love her. And but all that said, I'm surprised you guys haven't mutinied me by now. Mutinied? Yeah, that must be the word. Because you've been requesting Reckless Kelly for a long time, and a lot of you have requested Reckless Kelly, and I hadn't done anything yet, so this is my first Reckless Kelly song, and I'm doing Wicked Twisted Road, which will make some of you happy, and some of you might be marginally happy, but it goes like this. Well, first, Reckless Kelly, they're from Idaho, but they moved to Austin, Texas in 1996. So some of you are probably claiming them as your own by now. And so I got no say in that, that what you do is what you do. But this was requested, the song itself was requested by Kara Bragg, Hella 530, Wade Burns, Zeke Montgomery, Cowtown Customs, and 93 Drano. That's the specific song. And here are the people who've requested the group, maybe other songs or just Reckless Kelly. You got to do Reckless Kelly type of comment. But let's see. Drew Smithwick, Michelle Carlson, Jeff Weaver, Eric Cernesh, Wes Krug, CSO04, Shane Duhan, Sarah Emily, let's see, Rankin Timmons, Marissa Lobue, and the KVOK. Those are the boys, Dutch and Daryl over at the KVOK. They're closing in on 1,000 subscribers over there. They might have it by the time this thing's out. So check out their site. I love those guys. They're funny. They're different. They're not the anti-me, but maybe they are. I don't know. But all right, let's get into this. Let me put my headphones on. Wicked Twisted Road. This is a reaction. I don't know what this one's about. See my stone pony hat? I love this hat when I remember to wear it. Boop.
My first love was a wicked twisted road. I hit the 1,000,000 mark at 17 years old.
Wow.
Never saw the rainbow, much less a pot of gold. Yeah, my first love was a wicked twisted road.
There's a freedom in that.
My first love was a castle in the sky. Never thought I'd make it till I had the guts to try. Then I sat up in my tower while the whole world passed me by. Yeah, my first love was a castle in the sky.
I like this. I like a lot what they're doing already. I wonder if he's got a third first love.
My first love is fearless driving rain.
Yep.
Scared to death, I thought I'd never see her face again. They said God was crying, so I guess he felt my pain. My first love was a fearless driving rain. My first love was a wild, sinful night. I ran out with the big dogs, guess I had more bark than bite. I know I won the battle, but in the end I lost the fight. Yeah, my first love was a wild, sinful night.
far. It's captivating. The instrumentation, the lyrics especially, but the way he's singing them is a young man. And I formed an idea where, one, this guy loves a lot of things. He's not settled, obviously. But he's got all these first loves, which just suggests somebody who has a passion for life. And of course, I don't know where the song is going to go and if it's going to get resolved in a more, narrowed down way. Let's put it that way. But right now, it's still expansive because he's had these four first loves. And I don't think he's referring, metaphorically, first or literally to women. And, he was just analogizing them to like Castle in the Sky, Wicked Twisted Road, Fearless Driving Rain. But maybe those are like the way he's categorizing these women. I don't think so. I think he's just saying that, one, he wasn't settled on anything. He was young. And he had these various things that captivated his imagination. But we'll find out where it goes. But I love it when you can do this in a song, like not know what it's about, but keep someone's interest. Because it's not uncommon when people don't know what something's about, they bail. And this, I'm like even that much more in to find out where he goes with it, where they go with it. That's probably more appropriate, but I'm speaking of the vocalists.
My first love was an angry, painful song. Wanted one so bad I went and did everything wrong. Lesson in reality would come before too long. Yeah, my first love was an angry, painful song. My first love was a wicked, twisted road. Hit the million mile mark at 17 years old. I never saw the rainbow, much less a pot of gold. Yeah, my first love was a wicked twisted road. My first love was a wicked twisted road.
Okay. The way psychologically we process things in life sometimes, like when you look back in your life and your last memory might be the most impactful one. And so that to you is your first memory. But then you remember another thing that happened before that. And it was significant to you at the time. So that becomes your first memory. And then you think of something else. And then, you assign these as your first or most impactful memory, but they're all impactful. They're all you, one shaped the other. One might have led to another. I cannot say that that's what's going on in this song. I think odds are it's not. But this is what I'm thinking while I'm listening to it. Odds are, whatever, that would even mean. But what a contemplative song. Sometimes in life, there's a great joy in not knowing things. And as long as you're trying, as long as you do know some things, it's okay to say, I don't know. That's something I would advise people when they're getting married or, my gender. I love my gender, but I would school the young men to say, look, dude, it's okay to say, I don't know. And I say that to women too. Anybody, it's okay to say, I don't know. You don't have to show that you know everything, except when you're a teenager. Then, of course, you know everything. By the time you're 40, you pretty much don't know anything anymore. But it's okay to acknowledge it. And this is one of those songs where, is it a coming of age song? He touched on the songwriting aspect of it, and what was it? An angry, I don't know, it was an angry, it wasn't, he didn't, it wasn't a well-written song or it wasn't a well-done song. He didn't see the pot of gold. He didn't even see the rainbow, I think the lyric was as well, but. At 17, he had a million miles. So that tells me that's in his imagination. Like, that's how he's seeing his life going. Because at 17, you're not a semi-truck driver, and even still, you couldn't get a million miles in by then, right? Even at 1,000 miles a day, it would take you 3 years to get there, and you don't have your semi-license at 14. So I'm guessing it started in his imagination about how he was depicting his life going, and then how it actually went, because the song didn't work, and he didn't see the pot of gold. But I'm not sure, and there was a woman in there, I'm pretty sure. Wow. All right, I'm going to give a shout out again to you guys who recommended this. I'll be paying more attention to their stuff. Leave your comments as far as what you think it means. Some of you know what it means because you've heard it before. So you see me struggling trying to figure out the random ways it could go. And sometimes you like seeing that. Sometimes you might be squirming in your seat like, oh my God, the dude is missing it. Either way, it's fine. That's the nature of the beast. I'll take the hits and I'll take the compliments. I'll take it all. It is what it is. But all right, Kara Bragg, Hella 530, Wade Burns, Zeke Montgomery, Cowtown Customs, and 93 Drano. Hope that wasn't too painful for you. Seeing me go through that. But also Drew Smithwick, Michelle Carlson, Jeff Weaver, Eric Cernesh, Wes Krug, CSO04, Shane Duhan, Sarah Emily. Are you in the UK, Shane? That something tells me you might be in the UK. Sarah Emily, Rankin Timmons, Marissa Lobieu, and the KVOK. And I know you're not in in the UK, the KVOK. You be in Oklahoma. Thank you very much. The KVOK, Oklahoma. Thank you very much. All right, guys, that's it. Hope you enjoy. Oh, I got to rate that song. Holy crap, I almost forgot. Woo, that was really well done. 8.8. That's what I'm feeling out of that song. It's not quite a 9, but man, I mean, 8.8, as you guys know, is like extraordinarily high. That is a very well-crafted and done song, and I did like the lyrics. I thought it could have been resolved in a different way. And I don't mean necessarily pigeonhole the meaning and just sort of nail it down, but there would seem like something was missing, but maybe when you guys clarify what the meaning of the song was, that's purposeful. Or I just missed it, but I'm still great, beautiful, wonderful song. 8.8 Reckless Kelly. What is that? Wicked Twisted Road, not Lying Twisted Road. Wicked Twisted Road. That's it. All right, guys. Have a great day. See you on another video and keep rocking the country.